I go nap.
Huh?
I'm no good.
There's the queen. Anybody beat the jack of diamonds? Here I go.
Well, fancy getting away in a hand like that.
That's just because I do believe in taking risks. Now, I want something to tape me over each of you. Come on, it's time for another one, quick.
Well, that's enough for today.
No, come on, Joe, they just died.
I don't want to get the gambling fever.
Oh, come on, Joe.
No, I don't want to make a nubbit of it.
Just my luck of a hand like that.
Well, I could have beaten that. You'd have had to pay out on those, Joe.
Good job was one when I did. I lost too much already. I started with 7 pence 8 in the bank. And look, all I got is 5 pence. It's a mug's game, that's what it is.
You wanted him talking, Joe?
Who says? Natalia.
Hey, now better be quick.
What's all this about? You want me, Miss Elliot?
Where have you been?
Well, we're playing cards in the yard.
Didn't you, Busser?
Aye.
You did you? Well, they seem to be offended, too.
J.B. Butterworth, managing director of the Yordler Cheese Company. Where is he?
He's gone. Said he couldn't wait, so you've missed it.
Was he a big bloke with a pink face?
Aye, he was.
Well, I bumped into him just now.
Except he thought he was one of the ants from the packing shed. Instead of the owner of this place. No dignity.
What's the good of dignity? It only costs us money to keep it up.
Playing cards in your shirt sleeves with your own men as if you was one of them.
Well, aren't I? I've been making cheeses all my life and with my own hands most of the time. As soon as I forget that I'm a workman and kid myself on my top, that'll be the end of this here place. Well, what did he say?
He wanted to know if you'd reconsider his offer.
No, I won't. I'm not selling out to no Yordler cheese companies. If they're as clever as they think they are, let them come out into the open market and beat us at it.
Oh, Mr. King's been on the phone.
Oh, what did he want?
About some shares.
I'm not selling any shares in this concern.
Oh. This telegram's come.
No, no, this is from.
If you open it, you'll find out.
Don't be funny, I know. You know, I'm always nervous of these here things. Must have caught it off my mother, I suppose. Well, in for a penny, in for a pound. Well,
bad news.
Good news. What do you mean, bad news?
By the way, you jumped.
Well, I can jump a bit like, can't I? You're not going to stop me doing that, are you? It's from me daughter.
What, Miss Ellen?
No, not Miss Ellen. Ellen. She's always been Ellen here, and she always will be.
Well, she's been to a finishing school in France.
Why? What difference does that make?
Well, you sent her there to make a difference, didn't you? So you mustn't complain if it has.
Oh.
She'll expect to be called Miss Ellen now.
What, by me?
No, but by the rest of us when she comes back.
What do you mean when she comes back? She's coming back today.
Well, how was that, you know?
Well, I just told you.
No, yeah.
Well, one of us is a liar.
But not me.
Eh? Oh, I thought you were lying. You better read it yourself. I just phoned Mrs.
Here, I'll get through for you.
There's the phone.
Yes, I heard it too.
Well, answer it then.
It won't be for me.
Of course it won't be for you.
And what's the good of my answering it?
All because I tell you.
All right. Yeah, hold that.
Well, who is it?
I don't know. She keeps on saying hello.
Well, answer her then.
Well, what shall I say?
Oh, say hello.
Oh, same as she's doing. Hello? Hello? Oh, hello. Is Mrs. Hardcastle there?
Of course she is. She lives here.
Oh, just a minute. Mr. Hardcastle wants to speak to her. What do you mean, they say?
Well, she's got her hands full.
Well, that's right, ain't it?
You come over here and catch all of this and let me get down.
Oh, I get your meaning.
Well, what did you hang up for?
Well, why, it's not long enough for me to hold on to it if I'm to come to you.
What's to do?
They've all gone.
Here, give it to me. Look in the belt.
Yes. What? Today, never. Oh, Joe, how lovely. What time? 2:30. All right, I'll have everything ready.
Oh, I'm so excited, Alice, Miss Helen's coming home today.
Never heard of her. She's my daughter.
And Mr. Hardcastle's as well.
Of course. What are you talking about?
Well, I've only been here a few weeks. I can't expect to know everything.
We shall have to get her room ready.
off if I thought it was.
Oh, he must have made a mistake.
I should think so.
You didn't hear me. Well, would you believe it?
I would believe it.
Eh? Well, I shouted loud enough. What's the matter with her?
Perhaps it's something the matter with you.
What do you mean?
Well, if I was your daughter and I was out with someone, I wouldn't hear you shouting. Especially if you look like that.
Well, you mean she's ashamed of me?
Well, I'm ashamed of you and I'm not your daughter.
Well, goodbye. Thanks so much, Willis.
But aren't you going to introduce me to your father and mother?
Oh, well, I'm afraid I can't do that just now. You see, father's sure to be busy and mother's at Cannes.
Well, if it's impossible, it can't be helped.
No, it can't be helped.
So I'll just park you here and look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Rather.
Here's the florist shop.
It's terribly nice of you to give me all these.
And here's Wonky.
Oh, he's awfully sweet. But I'm sure I shan't know how to feed him.
Oh, nonsense. They gave me a book of instructions. If you follow those, you'll live for years.
You've simply loaded me with presents.
Well, you're worth it.
Mind your back. Mind your back.
Oh. Why did you look where you're going?
I said, mind your back.
That's no excuse.
Yes, it is. Hey, have you got a permit to see over these works?
What has that to do with you?
Well, it's my business to keep strangers out nosing about pinching our secrets.
You don't seem to remember who I am.
No, I don't. I don't want...
Well, if it isn't Helen. This lady is Miss Hardcastle.
That's what I called her.
No, you didn't. You called her by a Christian name.
Well, we're all Christian names here. How are you? Well, they haven't half made a real lady out of you.
Who is this man?
One of my father's workmen. I think you're forgetting our place.
Oh, I see. Two's company, three's a crowd. Say no more. I've been young myself.
That's the worst of these people, having known one when one was young. They'd have to take advantage.
I'd have them sacked if I were you.
I shall. Definitely I shall. Well, goodbye.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, tomorrow. Why, where's Wonky? That dreadful man's taken my dog. Here, come back. Didn't you hear me call?
Oh, that was you, was it?
Yes, it was me. Don't you see what you've got in your truck?
No, what is it?
It's my dog.
Oh, that's what it is.
Well, I'm sorry, there's no dogs allowed in here without a written permit. I should leave it at the gate.
You forget your place.
And you forget your place. Putting on all this side just because you've been to a finishing school. Little Nellie Hardcastle can never keep her stockings up.
Well, I'm not little Nellie Hardcastle anymore.
Oh, that's a pity. I liked you better that way.
I don't care what you like.
Oh, but you used to always bring me sweets and apples.
That was because I was sorry for you.
Oh. Well, now I'm sorry for you. Well, you'll grow out of it. If you don't, your head will burst. I can't waste any more time. Mind your back.
It's our Nellie.
Dad.
Oh, how you've grown. Yeah, I'm proud of you. I shouted you from the window just now, but you didn't hear me.
Oh, was that you?
I was that. You see, I haven't got me caught on. It was all untidy-like. I suppose you thought I was the man who came about the roof.
Yes, I didn't realize.
Of course you did, Nellie. Let's have a look at you. My word. That finishing school doesn't now finish you up, doesn't it?
About what it has done.
Oh, and I see you and Johnny been quick and chumming up again, huh?
We haven't lost a minute.
Where's the young man you was with?
Oh, he's gone.
Who is he?
Oh, he's a cousin of my biggest friend at school, Joe Fitzwilliam. We traveled back together. He met us at the station and ran me on here.
Bless my soul, what's this?
A dog.
Oh, that's a relief. I thought it was something that come out of the Gorgonzola. It's a good job you got all them flowers.
He gave me those as well.
Did he, though? Well, I never. You're going to be cut out.
Oh, I don't mind.
Oh, and talking about that, Dad, I wish you'd ask Miller here to be a little less familiar.
Miller?
That's me.
Oh, why? What's he been up to?
He's been very rude and personal, and I don't like it.
Oh, so you've been rude and personal, have you?
If he can't behave properly, I'd rather he didn't speak to me at all.
What have you been up to?
Well, I
object to being treated as if I were one of the girls in the factory.
Oh, so that's what you've been doing, is it?
No.
Yes, he has. He thinks he can take advantage because he's been here so long.
Oh, it's time he had the sack, eh?
Well, I didn't say that.
No, but I did. If you can't treat my daughter respectfully, my lad, the best thing for you is the sack.
Dad!
I'm not going to have anything here that you can be ashamed of. You've got the sack, my lad. Come up to the office and I'll confirm that. And bring her luggage with you. I'll take them, dearie. All right, Ducky, I'll open the door.
Why, it's Miss Ellen. How do you do, Miss Ellen? It used to be Helen before.
Ah, I see.
Yes, but we've grown up now.
That's right. That's just what this young man doesn't seem to understand. See, he gets his money for this week and next. He's sacked.
What?
Yes, I'm sacked.
I don't want him in my packing department no more. And before you go, young man, I'd like to give you a bit of advice. Come out here.
Well, do you think I've changed?
I think you're a credit to your school, Ellen. I just told your father I wish he'd gone to a finishing school to try and live up to you.
Yes, I wish he'd take a little more care of his personal appearance.
I'm always getting on to him about that. But I you can do more than I can.
Well, that's that.
And you've sacked him?
Well, I told him I didn't want him in my packing department no more. Better get along to your mother. She'd be bursting to see you.
You can't go, Miss Hardcastle.
Why not?
I've made an appointment for you with Mr. Butterworth.
What, the yonder cheese bloke?
Aye.
But I don't want to see him.
I think you ought to.
Well, who's to decide, you or me?
I've decided for you.
Oh, now we do know who's boss here.
Exactly. He'll be here any minute now, so you'll have to wait.
Oh, sorry, you'll have to go home on your own here, but I'll see you in a minute.
Good. Goodbye, Miss Ellis.
Goodbye, Miss Ellis.
Ready to move up?
Yes, Jack.
Well, take these things of Ellen's. Miss Ellen's.
I hope the van will be home as soon as the car. I have a lot to unpack.
Car? What car?
Why, yours, of course.
Oh, that I haven't used it for months. The chauffeur left and I didn't bother.
Oh, well, how do I get home?
Same way as I come in the morning, in this.
In this? But people might see me.
Well, it wouldn't be for the first time. Come on, jump in. Tell your mother I'll be back as soon as I can. Bye-bye.
Hello.
You?
Yes.
But I thought you were just George.
Well, so I was, but I got another job straight away. Aren't I lucky? Hang on, Datchet. You're off.
5, 7, 12. Oh, Mother, them Yodler people have been after me all day to sell the business to them.
Don't talk for a moment, Joe. I've just got to feel.
Oh, sorry, Mother. 28, 35.
That's all right. That's won't tell, Joe.
Not me. I've other ideas from that. Hey, home's just like home now the young'un's back.
Ah, but I doubt if we shall keep her long. She'll be thinking of marrying soon.
Well, she needn't go far to do that.
Meaning?
Young Johnny Miller. They were sweet as kids, and I fancy they're still sweet.
How do you know that?
Well, she hadn't been here 5 minutes till they was at each other just like cat and dog. That's the way sweethearts has.
But we wasn't like that, Joe.
Ah, but we was pre-war.
Oh. Not late, am I? My watch has stopped.
Hey, doesn't she look fine and handsome? Takes after me. And blow me if she hasn't got another dress on.
Well, I always change for dinner, then.
Dinner? So we're getting all about. I'd best get ready now.
What are you doing, then?
Getting ready for the groom.
I don't forget to undo your belt, Joe. His indigestion's been something cruel of late.
Aye, I go up like a balloon when my stomach is full. There's the girl. Will you go, Mother, or should I?
If someone don't come soon, I'll drop luck.
Shave. He was nearly unlucky. I thought the lock would go.
Ah, well, the missus as good as a mile. Duffel.
You best put him where you want him. I don't know where you want to sit, and my kettle's boiling up.
What a dreadful girl.
Hey, she's all right. She can scrub and she can scour.
Ah, but she can't cook spuds. Still, I'd rather have that than someone what was rude.
Hungry, dearie? Not very. No.
Ah, but you will be when you get your teeth into that pig strutters and suety pud.
Why don't you make the girl wait at table?
What do you mean, same as waiters does in public houses?
Private houses.
It's an idea, Joe.
Oh, why not? She's doing that.
I ring for her.
Ring for her. I'll get a sooner than that.
Alice, come here. You want it?
Yes?
Can you wait at table?
I don't mind.
Well, have a do.
I've no objection. Thanks.
Hey, that's not for you. That's for your mistress.
Then why'd you give it to me?
To Anne, to her.
Go on. She can reach. Well, really. And when do I get mine?
When we've finished.
Then why should I wait at table for that? I can wait in kitchen, same as usual. Stand by and watch you all eating and not get a bite myself. That's stuff, that is. There, Joe, now you've hurt her feelings.
Come on, now sit you down, we're all mucking together.
Is that table napkin?
It wasn't here by that table napkin. That was round suet pud.
I hope it was clean.
There you are, dear. Wipe your mouth with that. Another piece, Father?
No, thanks, Mother. I've had 2 whacks already. A fair blow down. Manners.
And you'll be room for tomorrow.
Why, what's on tomorrow?
Ah, I've been busy. We're having a grand party tomorrow for Aunt Nellie. I've been baking all afternoon.
That's fine. Have you asked all the folks?
Of course.
Gee, I forgot Mrs. Oakroyd. I'll have to phone her.
That'd be grand, won't it, Nellie?
Yeah.
What do you say, Alice?
Be a lot more washing up. All this lot got to be took away yet. Well, I'll help get
though. Have a mother, lend an airpin. Where do you keep him? All right. Yeah, there's no place like home.
No.
to us where you and Nick could have a nice long chat.
Yes, Ed. I wanted to have a chat with you.
Well, go ahead.
Well, you remember my telling you about Joe Fitzwilliam, my friend at school?
The cousin of the young man is more you over.
Yes. Well, she's asked me to stay for a few days with her uncle's aunt, whom she lives with.
Why not?
You don't mind?
Why should I?
Oh, I'm so glad. You see, Joan's aunt and uncle are Philip's mother and father.
Oh, and Philip's the young man has mortared you over.
Yes, Ed. How quick you are to pick things up.
Strikes me you're quicker than me at picking things up. I only met him this morning.
No, I've known him a long time. I met him in France.
What was he doing in France?
Oh, he's often there. On business.
Oh, and you've been carrying on with him while you've been at school, eh? I've often wondered what the teacher finished in school. Now I know.
Don't be angry, Daddy. He's awfully nice. He comes from a wonderful family. They're very well off.
Well, I'd like to meet him and give him the once over. Why didn't he stop so they could have met him today?
Oh, he had to get away. He was in a hurry.
Oh.
I'm so glad I told you, Daddy. I've been wanting to get off my mind all day. And now?
Where are you off to, Nellie?
To pack.
Pack? Unpack, you mean?
No, I've done that. Now I'm going to pack again.
Whatever for?
Well, you see, Joan said the only time convenient for them to have me was this weekend. So I'm going there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? But what about your mother's party?
Yes, that's a pity, but I'll be back in a few days. You're not angry about it, are you?
Angry? Not angry.
I'm so glad, Daddy. You are a sport.
Where are you going, dearie?
Only upstairs. Anything I can do for you?
No, thank you, Mommy. I can manage all right.
Well, that's done. Now we can have the rest of the evening to ourselves.
I'm not so good at evenings to ourselves.
What do you mean?
She's going away tomorrow.
She? Helen?
School chums invited her for weekend. She comes with a wonderful family, very well off.
But where's she going tomorrow?
Because it's the only time convenient for them.
Oh, I did hope she'd stay with us for a bit.
She's grown up too quickly. Perhaps we are a bit too old-fashioned for her.
She'll have to put off the party.
Well, I'm afraid our sort of party wouldn't appeal to her. Perhaps we ought to have got about a bit more, Mother.
Well, we've been very happy, Joe, and we know who our friends are.
I've been content enough, Mother, but they've got to see things through her eyes.
Maybe you're right.
Well, what the devil's that?
Oh, I'll answer it.
I do, otherwise Patterson might get at it.
Yes, this is Mrs. Hardcastle speaking.
Who is it?
Mrs. Fitzwilliam.
Oh.
I really rang up to tell Helen to come early tomorrow. I'd no idea you were in England. I thought you were at Cairns. Well, of course, we would have asked you as well.
What's she saying?
She's talking double Dutch to me. Something about Cairns. What's Cairns?
Moats. You go to me, I'll talk to her. Hello, is that Miss Fitz, what's it? Miss Fitzwilliams? Oh, pleased to meet you. I hope I see you well.
Oh, are you Mr. Hardcastle? How do you do? We had an idea that Mrs. Hardcastle was at Cairns. Or we would have asked you before. We would be so delighted if you would come and stay with us.
Hold on, will it? What's his name?
I know.
Shall we?
You know, why not?
That's right, why not? Why not? I mean, thank you kindly. Yes, very pleased, I'm sure.
That's splendid. We'll expect you tomorrow, then.
Well, thanks very much. Goodbye.
What's it mean, Joe?
That was his mother.
Whose mother?
Her son's.
But who's her son?
Philip.
Philip who? What's he got to do with us?
Well, Aunt Nellie's in love with him.
What? That's the first I've heard of it.
Well, haven't we just heard it yourself?
But why didn't you tell me then?
Well, he was washing up.
Oh, and what's Ken's got to do with it?
That's a proper puzzler, that is.
Was that the phone?
Aye.
Not for me, by any chance?
No, for us.
Oh.
From Mrs. Fitzwilliam.
Yes, and she's invited us to come and stop with her.
But you won't, of course.
Will we not?
Well, they've got a terribly big house, butlers and all sorts of servants.
Will it be a change for Mother not having to wash up?
Well, I don't think you'd like it very much. They dress for dinner every night.
Of course they do. It gets cold about that time in the evening.
She means evening dress, Joe.
Oh, I get you, meanie. Ball shirt, same as I wear when I go out with the bus. Oh, I can do the dolly nooks, so can't I, Mother?
No one better, love.
So we all be by the same train, what?
Train, Joe? What's the matter with the car?
forgot we had one. We haven't had it out since the chauffeur left.
Do it good to take it out now.
Ah, but who's going to drive it?
You'll get plenty to drive it.
Ah, but he'll have to be the same size as the other fella, otherwise the uniform won't fit him.
So long as he can get into the coat, he'll be all right. He'll be sitting down all the time.
So now we've all got to pack.
Yes. Well, I'll run along and get on with mine.
Oh, she's gone, and I wanted to ask her if she knew anything about cans.
Joe, dear, car the door.
Coming, love.
Car the door, Nelly, dear.
That's ready. You're not going like that.
Why, yes, dear, journey won't hurt me close.
We're going to do you credit, lass. Now, who's going to sit in front? You know what my stomach is.
Well, car riding doesn't upset my stomach, but it does give me an headache.
Well, I'd like to get some air, so I'll sit in the front.
Well, that's settled. Are we ready?
Oh, Daddy, don't carry those yourself.
Well, not have done it all midnight. What's to stop me now?
But you mustn't do it when we get there.
Oh, don't you worry, lass. I won't do out of miss. When in Rome, do as Romans does, eh? We're up in.
You again?
Yes. We always seem to be sitting next to each other, don't we? You seem to like it.
I don't.
Oh, I thought you'd done it on purpose.
If I'd known you were driving, I would have gone by train. You're a rotten driver, and I hate sitting next to you. I wish I'd gone in the back.
Oh, it's too late for that.
Well, that's the worst blow I've had for a long time.
My dear old Fitzwilliam, I don't say that those shares are no good. But I do say that things are looking pretty groggy all around them. The country's ripe for revolution. If that comes along, where shall we be?
I don't know.
Seabrook has got to keep in touch with me on the phone as to how things are going. But he says that the fighting, when it starts, is bound to take place right over our oil fields. So it doesn't matter who wins, we'll lose.
What's the best thing to do? Ever heard of Hardcastle little Gruyere cheese?
Well, we always have them at home. Why?
They're coming to stay with us.
What, the cheeses?
Yes, all three of them. Father cheese, mother cheese, and daughter cheese. They'll be here at any moment now.
Is his father any good for our shares?
Not a hope, I should imagine. Hard-headed businessman. But the daughter, I believe, is quite presentable. Hence the milk and the coconut.
Or the cream and the cheese, what?
Oh, very good. Thank you.
Excuse me. I must do my duty as host and show them a little old English hospitality. I hope that something comes of it.
Well, here we are. Very nice of you to have us. This is my lunch. Meet the wife.
I'm pleased to meet
you. I really.
The butler.
The butler? Well, I don't know. Why, he's as well dressed as I am.
How do you do, Mr. Hardcastle? How do you do, Mrs. Hardcastle?
Very well.
Oh, and this must be little Helen that my dear Joan has spoken so much about. Oh, Helen, I'm so pleased you've come. My father and mother. How do you do?
Pleased to meet you. Go on, sir, summit.
Hope you're well. Norman. The Hardcastles have arrived.
Why on earth did somebody tell me, how do you do, my dear Mr. Hardcastle?
Well.
How do you do, Mrs. Hardcastle?
Naturally.
And this must be little Helen. Well.
I think I'm ahead of your gun.
Well, I never. So you've got here already. Did you have a nice run?
Lovely, thanks.
Well, won't somebody introduce me to your people?
Oh, this is my father, my mother.
Well, pleased to meet you.
Glad to know you.
Well, not nearly as pleased and as glad as I am.
What's
the butler's name? Perkins, I think.
Perkins?
Jorkins, madam.
Jorkins? I think you'd better take the luggage upstairs.
Yes, madam.
All right, my young man will see to that. Hey, Johnny! Oh, you're just in time. Take the stuff up.
Okay, Joe, where to?
He'll tell you. Oh, you don't know each other, do you? My chauffeur, their butler.
I do.
Now we all know each other, don't we?
Oh, Booking. I think you'd better take that chauffeur to the garage.
Very good, madam.
Joan and I will take you to your room.
Oh, thank you very much.
What I want to know is why you got to dress up like the state.
Well, you know what you said, Joe. When in Rome, do what the Romanians do.
Ah, the Romanians doesn't dress like this. They've got too much sense.
Well, you said there wasn't any sacrifice you wouldn't make for our Nelly.
Ah, but I didn't know what you'd expect of me. Ah,
look at me now. I just want to start it.
Joe, do be more careful. You'll ruin it.
Oh, Dad, haven't you got any further than that?
I've been further than this a dozen times, but every time I try to put my tie on, the old lock goes.
Well, let me help you. Now, keep quite still and don't get hot and bothered.
Oh, it's a dog's life, this is. Hang on to the collar. Oh, if you only knew how uncomfortable I am.
Oh, don't grumble, Joe. If you knew what I'm suffering under the arms from this dress, you wouldn't say another word.
What about me? I feel as if I was handcuffed.
Now, then, there are just one or two things I want you to remember, Dinah. Don't speak with your mouth full.
No.
No. Don't talk about the cheese factory.
Why not?
Because we're in very high society, and anything connected with trade is bad form. Don't push your plate away when you've finished. Don't dip your bread in the gravy, and don't eat off your knife.
Otherwise, I can act quite natural.
Yes, Dad. Now, you will watch it all for me, won't you?
Of course I will. If they think we are people as goes to cans, oh, we can swank.
Grand. Now, let me see what you look like.
Well?
You look like a titled gentleman.
I feel like a titled fool.
Let's go out and toast.
I'd love to. So would I.
Have another glass of port, Hardcastle.
Ah, I don't mind if I do. It's nice and tasty.
Quite cheap. Only costs 130 shillings a dozen.
No, oh, we don't pay anything like that at home, do we, Mother?
Oh, no, nothing like that. I suppose you get a really expensive dress, eh?
Oh, yes.
You lay down much at a time?
No, I'm up at 6 every morning.
Oh, jolly good.
That's very witty.
I suppose you go north for the grouse.
Well, we usually go to Sainsbury's.
Really? You mean the cart of Sainsbury's? They're the finest shoot in the country.
The cart of We've got quite a tiny shooting box in our garage here. A very pleasant, but quite small.
Ah, like my kitchen at home.
Yes. I suppose it would be about that size. You must have an enormous place.
Oh, it's not as big as all that. I only employ about 70 men.
What, 70? And the female staff?
Oh, there's only about 30 of them.
Joe, you remember what Nelly said?
Oh, I'm not as strong about the... By the way, you know cans?
Cans?
Oh, yes, rather. But I prefer something more English. Cows, for example.
Oh, I'm very fond of cows. So gentle.
I've had to lay my yard up. She hasn't been in deep water for 12 months.
We have. Oh, fishing, eh? Oh, old Fitz has got her water on the tay.
I once had water on the knee.
Really? Stopped you hunting, I suppose.
Well, I'm not very fond of blood sport myself.
Well, I've never tasted blood sport, but if it's as good as this, I've no complaints.
You certainly are a wag, Mr. Hardcastle. Witty as well as wealthy, eh?
Well, I don't know about the wit.
But the wealth's all right, huh?
I think I'll go to bed now.
Well, we all will. Are you ready, Mother?
Aye, I think we've talked quite enough for one evening.
Good night, then. June, you'll see that Helen gets everything she wants.
Yes.
You must tell us more about yourself tomorrow, Hardcastle.
I will.
Good night.
Hello.
Good night. Good night. As they
don't get up at
6:30
tomorrow.
Oh, dear.
Good night,
John.
Good night.
Good night, Mrs.
We've
Hardcastle.
We've
had
a red jump
in
time, we have.
Good night.
Good night, dear.
Quaint people, aren't they? Most attractive.
Quite. If I'd known how attractive, I don't think I'd have invited her down here.
Just think of 30 female servants. You must be rolling in it.
You're telling me. Smell them a mile away.
Yes, we're not the sort to be interested in oil shares, I'm afraid.
No, that type's the hardest to learn. Philip's the lucky one.
What do you mean?
Well, the girl's in love with you.
Oh, rot.
No, it isn't. I was watching her dinner.
Why don't you follow it up? A wealthy man should do your family a lot of good.
Oh, thanks, but I happen to be in love with Joe.
Now, listen to me, my boy. Old Hardcastle would do anything for his daughter. Get her tied up and he'll do anything to you.
You're not seriously suggesting that I should get myself engaged to Helen.
Well, why not?
You can always break it off.
Break it off when?
Give you the tip. After all, if he buys our oils and loses all his dough, you wouldn't want to marry his daughter then, would you?
Oh, I see.
Up she goes and shoes for the baby.
Hello, what are you doing?
Just a little game, sir.
Are you playing, Johnny?
Yes, sir.
You're not playing for money.
On a halfpence. You don't disapprove, sir.
I most certainly do.
It's only a halfpenny at times, sir.
Disgraceful. Make it a penny and I'll have a go. Revolution's practically certain. We've got to work fast.
He may turn it down flat.
Oh, no, he'll be all right. These self-made men are always the same as soon as they get out of their own line of country. Come on, let's fight.
I'm all for it.
And I win fourpence.
I'll throw you if you're fourpence.
I shall win.
Oh, chance it. One throw?
One throw.
That's fine.
Six.
Four. Oh, where's the other? There's one under the car.
Well, that's where they come over here somewhere, eh?
What have you lost?
About I'm in.
Val Captain.
Oh,
Mr. Hardcastle, I was just looking for you. I want your opinion on a Rembrandt I've just bought.
A remnant?
No, a Rembrandt.
Oh, well, of course, you know, I don't know a note about motor cars.
No, it's not a motor car, it's a picture. You're interested in pictures, aren't you?
Oh, I enjoy a good picture. Ginger Rogers is my favourite.
No, this is rather a different sort. A painting. Come and have a look at it.
I don't mind.
That's right, come on.
Well, what do you think of me as a horse?
Oh, wonderful. But then you're a wonderful girl altogether.
Oh, I bet you say that to all the girls.
Oh, no, I don't. You've got something no other girl I know has got.
Have I?
Yes. Have you ever been in love?
Have you?
I am now.
With Joan?
Joan? I'm not in love with her.
But I thought you were.
Oh, no, I like her, but love's different. It's something that takes you suddenly.
When you least expect it.
Yes, exactly. It was only last night, just after you'd gone to bed, that it was born in on me what a marvelous girl you are. You're a picture.
Ah, it's a grand frame. You've got a bargain there, Fitz.
Well, have you got a cheap that summit? It isn't new, you know. I suppose you got it second hand.
Yeah, it only cost 3,000.
3,000 pounds? Why, it's all cracked.
Paintings are Fitz's hobby. That's Sir Joshua Reynolds.
Sir Joshua Reynolds?
Don't be daft. That's
a young woman.
Painted by Sir Joshua Reynolds.
Oh. Do you know that the paintings in this house must be worth £100,000?
Nobby, £100,000? Yeah, you must make a pocket of money.
We don't do it today, do you, Gregory?
No, but of course we stick to the stuff we understand. Oil.
Yes, that's where all the money is these days. Anglo-Peruvian oil share.
You must have a tidy few of them.
Not so many as we'd like, eh, Fitz?
Why don't you buy some more?
More? None to be had. You can't get a look at them. We have a man in the city with instructions to buy everyone he can lay his hands on. Himself.
Yes, and if you ever put us on to any, we'll give you a handsome recall.
Hey, I'll remember that.
Oh, come on. Ah, Philip. And you both arrived just in time to admire my new picture.
Well, I wanted to admire mine. We're engaged.
What?
Yes, Daddy. I've said yes.
Well, I'll go to Jerusalem.
You're not going to disapprove.
No, but it's not me all of a bump. I thought that you...
You never even gave your old father a hint, you young devil.
Congratulations both on you. What a couple.
Excuse me, sir. Mr. Seabrook on the phone, sir. He would like to speak to Mr. Gregory urgently.
Thank you very much. Excuse me, will you? Is that you, Seabrook? Gregory speaking. What's the news? What? Are you sure? Revolution's bound to happen. Only a matter of days. What? What? It's only fine to say sell out, but who to? Anyway, thanks for the tip. Goodbye. Extraordinary coincidence. You know, we were just talking about Anglo-Peruvians. Well, there's old Seabrook on the line. He's got a hold of a block of 50,000 of them.
What? Where on earth did he get them?
Well, some executors selling out. He offered them to me at 42 shillings, so I said yes.
Half each, eh?
Well, he rang me up, old boy.
Well, hang it all. You're not going to stick to them all yourself.
Hey, you mustn't be greedy.
Oh.
You're right, sir. Selfishness doesn't pay. How's Fitz?
Good man. But what about our friend here? We can't leave him out, especially now he's a relative.
Oh, of course not. I tell you what, sir. You can have half mine.
And half mine. 25,000 in all. And very cheap, too, at 42 shillings.
Well, I don't want to appear ungrateful, but I don't want them.
What? You must be mad.
I've been in cheese all my life, and I reckon I'll stop in cheese or not, and I'll catch a cold.
But, my dear sir...
Well, I'll think it over, but this engagement stuff's got me all at sea. Well, we'd better go and see what your mother's got to say about it, lass.
Oh, Mummy'll be all right.
Well, I can't make him buy.
He said he'd think it over.
There's no time for that. Seabrook said on the phone the market may bust in 24 hours.
So I've got engaged for nothing.
No, you haven't. You've got engaged to be married. And there's the solution.
What, marry her?
Well, why not? He's not the sort of man to cut his daughter off, is he now?
But I don't want to marry her. Anyway, I can't get married in 24 hours.
No. But you can elope.
But, my dear, you've made me very happy.
you're happy and he's happy, I'm sure there ought to be naught but happiness in it for everybody.
You're darlings, both of you.
My word, look at the time. I must get changed.
Well, there's somebody in the finishing school after all. It's got our Nelly right amongst the gentry.
That's right, Joe, but I'm thinking they'll take a bit of keeping pace with.
Aye, all this talk about yachts and shooting boxes.
We're not so well to do as them and never will be.
Not out of cheese, but we might out of oil.
What do you mean, Joe?
Well, Mother, you'll admit this Fitzwilliam chap wouldn't have saved me.
Well, I don't like it. That's not the point. We fed you and told you all your life. You've never earned a bob. Well, here's where you do.
You've got a duty to your parents, my boy.
Yet you want me to put all the blame on the mater and tell Helen that we've got to elope because she objects to the marriage.
Oh, your mother won't mind. She's been accustomed to taking the blame all her life.
Then what about Joe?
It's to her advantage, too. If we go down, so does she.
Well, I must explain to her.
I'll take her out tonight, before you elope.
And then don't get back too late. You've got to get the Hardcastle girl away before the news breaks. There's no good me phone in the bank that won't be written word.
But he could slip over in the car. It's only 50 miles.
The car, I keep forgetting we had one.
I haven't been long, have I? Oh, I feel so happy.
Be a good girl, Lily. Run round and tell Johnny Miller I want the car in 10 minutes. I'm going home.
Going home? Whatever for?
Well, I've got to see the bank and the solicitors.
A marriage settlement, Dad.
Now, don't you ask questions, Luke. Run along.
All right.
Well, hope I'm doing right.
I don't see how you could do otherwise, Joe. We're in with the smart set, and when in Rome, do as the Ruritanians do.
The Romans, Mother, Romans.
Miller, will you bring the car around in 10 minutes?
Yes, madam.
That's all?
No, it isn't.
What do you mean?
Harvey.
What?
Well, all this side.
How dare you?
Oh, I'm awfully brave. I'm not even frightened of you. I'm going to tell you something for your own good.
I won't listen to you.
Yes, you will. Do you know, a few years ago, you were quite a decent kid. Until you started kidding yourself you were a big lady.
Well?
Now your head's so big you don't even know where you are. Do you know, at one time I thought of marrying you.
You marrying me?
Oh, I wouldn't now. Not if you and your father and your mother went down on their knees to kiss me. That's all you can go.
And I wouldn't marry you if you were the last man on earth. Thank heaven you're not. And you may be interested to know that I am going to be married.
What?
To Mr. Philip Fitzwilliam.
Well, I'll eat my hat.
And I hope it gives you indigestion.
Well, young man, I suppose you've been up to keep down.
I shan't be sorry, Joe.
Now that you lie, no wonder. Look at the time. Well, I think I've done a big thing. Made packets of money, not only for myself, but for all my friends as well.
You've made money all your life, Joe, haven't you?
Not real money, not chunks of it.
Oh, what do you want with chunks of it?
Oh, I don't rightly know, but it's useful stuff to have about the house.
In my mind, Joe, money's like beer. Good to have enough of, but bad to have too much of. You get drunk on money, same as you can on beer. I'd sooner stay sober.
Meaning I'm not?
Meaning I'm going to bed.
Oh, you're not the only one. Oh, I mustn't forget to leave this note with my check for Mr. Fitzwilliam. You see it first thing in the morning.
Night, John.
Good night, Johnny.
Do you think anyone heard?
No. Everybody's a bit out of it.
Helen.
Oh, darling, don't start that again. It's inevitable. I haven't got a bob, neither of you. How could we get married?
Why can't we stay as we are?
On what? Now, I've got to get through with this. I've got a duty to my parents.
But what about your duty to me?
Well, I'm thinking of that, too. If we go down, what happens to you? You'll have to go out and earn your own living. Typist or a waitress.
You're in love with Helen.
No, I'm not. I'm in love with what she's got, money. But it's you I want.
Then this is goodbye.
There's such a thing as divorce.
And you're leaving with her at 2 o'clock.
Yes.
Then I think I'll go. Good luck.
Aye, they did it all for our Nelly's sake. Have a mind to go tell her now.
Joe, what are you thinking of? 2 o'clock in the morning? But a child would be in bed and fast asleep long ago.
other, don't we?
How dare you? What do you think you're doing?
Taking you for a ride, lady.
Man, she
yes, but why?
Because she loves him, I suppose.
Ah, but that's not the way to do things.
No, it isn't, Joe, not where we come from. But here everything seems different. We got in with a fast step, and perhaps this is what they all do. Oh, Joe, why didn't we stop in the station to which we belong?
Station? We seem to have got into a junction. Everybody's going different ways.
Yes, perhaps his father and mother know something about
perhaps
it.
Perhaps they do. We'll go and ask them.
Oh, come on.
Wiltshire bacon and real farm eggs. Ah, there's many a poor child who'd be glad of this. Do you know,
When I was a Boy Scout, I won a medal for cooking eggs and bacon. I put more taste in them than anyone else. Delicious. A little bread in the fat, I think. Always tastes better in the open, don't you think?
Can't you stop talking?
I'm not talking to you. Nicest cup of tea I've had in a long, long time. What more could a man want? Beautiful breakfast, beautiful country, and a beautiful girl looking at him.
I'm not looking at you.
Oh. Yeah, she is a pretty girl. If you can read characters by faces, I'd say she's got a swollen head.
What?
Oh, yes. Discontent shown by the way the corners of the mouth turn now. Obviously selfish, pig-headed, obstinate, and greedy. Otherwise, you're all right.
And what about you?
Well, what about me?
Bumptious, conceited, arrogant, greedy.
I'm not greedy.
Yes, you are. Your mouth's so full you can hardly talk.
Well, I thought you didn't want me to talk.
Feeding your face. Never asking me if I'm hungry.
Well, you had your chance. Now it's too late.
Then what do I do?
Go and cook some for yourself, you want it?
Yes.
Well, every young girl that thinks of getting married ought to learn how to cook.
You beast. Ow!
Put some butter on it.
Quick, hold this. What can we do? We should have put fire to it. No, it's salt.
Well, there isn't any.
I know.
That's grand. Now what do you use for tea?
Oh, dear, what can I do?
Well, you can't cook, that's certain. I should go home.
Well, I can't walk all the way in these shoes.
Well, who's asking you to? Come on, get in the car.
You're taking me back.
Yes. I'm tired of playing nursemaid to a spoiled child.
And I suppose you think this is a cure.
No, you need a good spanking. I'm taking you home to your father. Otherwise, I shall do it myself.
Yes.
Hi. Into the back, please.
Why?
Well, you might settle out to the engine this time. Here.
Looks as if they were moving.
Up there loafing too.
Oh, shut up.
This needs looking into. Come on. Well, if it isn't my old friend Gherkin, Forkin.
Yes, it's me.
Oh, what's happened?
What hasn't? The balloon's gone up.
Well, where is everybody?
Gone.
Gone?
Yes, they found their mug and scarpered.
Well, who was their mug?
Why, you're dead, of course.
Oh.
Where's Mr. Hardcastle?
He's gone too. Holding the baby in both his arms.
What baby?
Millions and millions of oil shares which they kidded him on to buy.
Oh, aren't they any good?
No, nothing of the Fitzwilliams is any good. There, there, don't take on so. We're all in this together. He owes me £3.15 in wages. And me other shirt's got took with the furniture. Could I keep a stiff upper lip?
Where are Mr. and Mrs. Hardcastle?
The Palace Hotel, London.
The Palace Hotel? Come on, we'll go there at once.
One minute. Ain't you got young Fitzwilliams' car?
Yes, but what about it?
Nothing, only if there's a bloke here from the car shop waiting to take it back.
So be careful you don't run into him. Well, what's he like?
Well, he's tall. Look out, he's coming now.
Whoa, come on. Yeah, this way.
Yes, sir?
Oh, where to bring me two double whiskies?
I won't have one, Joe.
Let me finish. I was going to say two double whiskies in one glass.
Very good, sir.
Joe, aren't you overindulging yourself?
What else is there to do? I've lost my daughter, I've lost my money, and now I'm going to lose the factory.
You won't lose that, Joe.
It's got to be sold.
To be sold? Why?
Well, I can't let their mother blokes that bought oil on my advice go down the drain. I must make it right with them. Well, how much?
£4.6, sir.
Struth. They know how to charge here. Then you want to tip.
Thank you, sir.
Well, how would you like 25,000 Anglo-Moruvian oil shares?
Oh, no, sir.
Oh, well, there are. There's sixpence.
Thank you very much, sir.
Even he knows better than I do. Well, here's to the biggest fool in London.
I don't know why we are in London.
Because I've things to do about selling the factory. And because I haven't got the guts to go back and face the music.
You'll be able to face it better when we're old, Joe.
That's right, Mother. Then I can get in touch with them yodelers and arrange the sale.
Tell the place where you worked
to send
what kept us all
our
married lives.
It's got to go. Don't cry, Mother. That won't do no good.
I can't help it.
I can't sit here. I've got to move about.
Where are you going to?
I don't know. Just stroll about and think.
But it's raining outside.
Well, with outside as well. What a lot of water there is about you.
Mother.
ladies and gentlemen, we must ask you not to block the doorway. You can come in and shelter if you like. I think you'll find it very interesting.
100, 150, 250, 300, 500, 500 pounds. That's the sort of bidding I like to hear, gentlemen.
750,
1,000. 1,000 pounds. Now, 1,000 pounds I bid, gentlemen. 1,000 pounds, any advance upon 1,000 pounds. For the first time, 1,000 pounds. For the second time, at 1,000 pounds. For the third and last time, 1,000 pounds. And now we arrive at the last lot of the day, gentlemen. By instructions of the underwriter, the steamship Mari, at present on the rocks on the Isle of Man.
Will she be floated to the owner's expense?
You'll buy her, she is, gentlemen, including all salvage. And there is no guarantee that she will still be on the rocks by the time you get to her. Now then, if any of you gentlemen wish to make a speculation, here's your chance. Now, will anyone make me an offer?
What's the railway fare at the Isle of Man?
Apparently, the Isle of Mull, sir, is about £3.
All right, then I'll start the bidding at that.
Now, come along, gentlemen, come along. Why, what's the matter with you? Why, don't let the rain damp your ardor? Now, will anyone start me at £100? £100. Now, come along, gentlemen. Why, there are many of you here who flick more on a horse that can't run. Now, come along, gentlemen, come along. We all want to get home. Now, then, will anyone start me at £100? Thank you, sir. Now, I have a sum of £100, gentlemen. Going for the first time at £100? But... Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but I've just been informed that there's a reserve of £150. May I say £150, sir? Thank you, sir. Going for the first time at £150. For the second time at £150. For the third and last time at £150. Yours, sir, at £150.
May I have your name, sir?
What?
Your name, sir.
My name? Hardcastle. Why?
Mrs. Hardcastle said, will you wait? She'll come down to you.
Thanks. So now I can hand you over to your rightful owners.
Yes.
And go off duty.
That will be a relief, won't it?
Yes, rather. It's been an awful responsibility.
Have I been an awful responsibility?
Yes. Well, looking after anything that doesn't belong to one is a responsibility, isn't it?
Depends upon if it's of any value. If it's only an annoyance and an expense. Probably the owners of which it never had been returned. You don't expect any reward, do you?
Not unless I can keep it in my trouble.
That wouldn't be much for a war, would it? You'd have to feed it and clothe it. I don't expect you'd get much gratitude from it.
Why not?
Because it's got the best parents in the world. It's been perfectly rotten to them. So why should you expect any better treatment?
Because I think it's learned its lesson. It's going to be a good girl for the rest of its life.
I'll tell you one thing.
What's that?
It's going to try.
Oh, there you are, dearie. Are you all right? Oh, my goodness, what a day. For goodness sake, let's go and sit down.
Oh, Mummy, forgive me.
Oh, I forgive you. It's you I can't never forgive.
Me? What have I done?
Running away with my daughter.
He didn't. He saved me from running away with the wrong man.
What? Oh, well, it's past my understanding. Your father will have to sort it all out.
Well, where is Dad?
Sorting himself out in the rain.
What's he in the rain for?
It's raining, I suppose. You don't have to worry about him. He's been drinking a terrible lot of whiskey without water. It's time he had some.
Has he lost all his money?
I don't know what he's lost. It's beyond me, but he's got to sell the factory.
Oh, Mother.
You don't mean that.
I do. It's all gone down with the wreck.
Wreck? Then you heard that.
Heard what?
A boat one.
What?
A wreck called the Maori on the Isle of Mull. Return fare £5.18 on the rocks. No one can get to it but the seagulls, and they don't want to.
Joe, what are you talking about?
I don't know. That comes of walking about in the rain.
But, Daddy, don't you know me?
Of course I know you.
You know me, Joe?
I know the both of you. What's to do?
Well, I ran away and I've come back.
Oh, did you?
Aren't you glad to see me?
I'm past being glad about anything.
Oh, I'll have to take him home.
That's what I want to be, Mother, home.
Oh, come along, darling. Come and get your things together. I'll pay the bill.
You'll have to. I'm skinned. That's all I've got, oil.
Well, Anne, this will probably help us. Received from Mr. Hardcastle the sum of £150 for the wreck of the steamship Mary on the Isle of Mull with all salvage rights.
Then he has bought a wreck. The first time he's ever been unfaithful to me.
Where's the Isle of Mull?
That's where your Uncle Annie lives.
Then perhaps he'd know something about it.
Well, he ought to. He lives there. I mean about the wreck.
Look here, we'll send him a telegram.
That's a good idea.
There's some forms over there. Now, what's his name?
Hardcastle. Carton, of course, same as his brothers. What do you expect him to be, Fitzwilliam?
What's his address?
The Isle of Mull.
At Isle of Mull, can you inform me?
They wouldn't have bought them if it hadn't been for me.
You gave them an honest tip. You are not to blame.
Well, I say I am. I've always spoofed you. I was a good businessman, but I'm not.
It's just hard luck.
Well, I don't intend them to lose. It's all my fault, and I'm going to pay.
You can't. You can't afford it.
We'll see about that. Ring up them yodelers. They've always wanted to buy this place. They can have it now.
You don't mean that. You can't. You mustn't.
Oh, I mustn't. Mustn't I? What's the number? You needn't bother. I've just remembered it.
Young man, have you any messages for Hardcastle?
I'll look, madam. Yes, the wire. That's for you. Give it to me.
What does it say? Yeah. Look! We must go to Biggleswold at once. What's the next train for Biggleswold?
Never mind about a train. I've got a car.
Whose car?
Dear Philip, it's the only thing we'll ever get from them.
Oh, so we have. Come on. You wait till I get my bag.
Mr. Hardcastle, sir?
Oh, that's me.
I was told to look out for you, sir. The director's waiting in the boardroom. You come this way, sir.
Well, gentlemen, if you leave everything to me, I think we'll get all we want.
May I suggest we warn them in the office? We don't want to be disturbed.
Good idea.
I do hope he hasn't sold the factory yet.
No, he hasn't had time. There's all kind of agreements to be drawn up. We'll stop him yet.
What are we doing now?
Detective, why don't we get on the straight?
Mr. Hardcastle, sir.
How do you do, my dear sir? How you have met Mr. Green.
How do you do? How
do you do? Mr. Pervright.
How do you do?
Now, please take a seat over here, will you? I'll put your coat down there, thank you.
What if he is in the boardroom? I wish to speak to him. But it is urgent. I must speak to him. Rubbish, do as I tell you. I must.
Provided always.
What, another one?
Well, this is just...
Half a minute. That's the six provided always. I've counted them. Whenever there's a clause that might be in my favour, it's always plastered with provided always.
I'm afraid, my dear sir, this is our contract.
Well, it doesn't take a second sighter to see that it isn't mine.
How much further is it now?
About 20 miles.
There's a shortcut across the field over a stile. Can't we take that?
Not in this.
Oh! Mother, your head's gone. Well, that's a blessing. I never did like it. Now I'll have to get a new one.
The Hardcastle seems so dissatisfied with our agreement. Perhaps he'd prefer to call the whole thing off.
But you were anxious to buy a week ago.
Quite. But you weren't so anxious to sell. Now the boot is on the other foot. You're not quite so anxious to buy. I don't care two hoots if we do or not. So you see the situation, my dear sir.
I do.
Shall I go on reading?
Mr. Hardcastle.
He's in the boardroom.
Well, then take us up there, quick.
I'm sorry, not to be disturbed.
But who says?
My orders are not to be interrupted until they ring.
But look here.
Now, it's more than my job's worth.
But I'm his lawful wedded wife.
Oh, maybe she'll want to keep out.
How dare you? How dare you suggest that you
may? I don't know.
Well, ring through.
I daren't.
Well, I will.
You won't.
That's right, Father. We're on the way
too far. Go.
Yes, what is it? What is it? Told not to ring up while we were busy. Who? I'll tell him. A man named Jessel wants to speak to you.
Jessel? Oh, Jessel. Tell him I'm busy.
He can't see you. He's busy.
What's he say?
He can't see us. He's busy.
Did you speak to Joe himself?
No.
Then I don't believe a word of it. Here, let me...
No, you don't.
Miss Elliot.
Did you get our wire?
Here it is. Have you stopped him?
From what?
Signing contract.
We can't get hold of him.
They won't let us speak to him on the phone.
Same with me. It's a put-up job. The buying factory for an old song. I know he wouldn't sign if I could show him this. Here, let
no,
me
you play. Don't.
Well, then you must...
Not on your life.
Well, I'm his daughter.
That's nothing to do with me. Now, she can break the law again. The person that passes here gets this. Idea.
What is it?
Does this go up?
Yes.
Well, pull me up.
What for?
A couple of quid. Here, I want each of you. What will the union think of this? Never mind about the union. Boardroom, quick. Come on. Don't start floor. Right.
Pull up.
Here we go.
Window to keep the drop down.
I'm coming with you, Jerry.
Come on.
Come on. Here we are.
wouldn't it?